Today, in this video, we will be covering two topics that are electric power and electrical energy. The first thing that we will be starting is electric power. Now see, power is not a new word. Power is something that tells us that a body can do how much of work in how much of time. That is power. Some have strong power, some have less power. A person having strong power can do work more efficiently and very fast. But a person who is weak, which has less power, will do that work in more interval of time. So power is something that is related to work and time. So the definition of electric power is, it is defined as rate of doing work. This is the definition of electric power, rate of doing work. Formula of power, it is denoted by symbol P. Formula is W divided by T. SI unit of power is watt, or you can use capital W. Or there is one more power, there is one more unit of power, that is work per time. So work is in joule per second, J/S. So the SI is watt, or you can write joule per second. Now what, you must have heard this word many times, watt. When you go to buy any electrical appliance, bulb, tube, anything, there is a power given to it, 100 watt bulb, 100 watt tube, 0 watt bulbs. So that is the word that you have heard in your day-to-day life also. So SI unit is watt. The formula, basic formula, is W by T, but it has some other formulas also. So you can write other formulas. E is equal to VI. One more formula of power is VI. Another formula of power, if you put value of V equals to IR, what you get? I square R. So one more formula of power can be I square R. Can make I square R. There's one more formula of power. If you put I is equal to V by R over here in VI, the formula of power can be V square by R. So power has basically how many formulas? Four formulas. One is W by T, that is the basic formula of any power, human power, mechanical power. But the main formula is VI, then I square by R, and then V square by R. So it has how many formulas? Four formulas. Fine. So this is electric power. I am telling you again that it is defined as rate of doing work. The formula is W by T. That is the basic formula. SI unit is watt. And there are other formulas also. There's VI, then I square R. How I square R? If you put value of V in VI, IR, it becomes I square R. If you put value of I, V by R over here, so you get V square by R. So there are how many formulas? Four formulas that you have to remember while solving numericals related to electric power. Now the next topic is electrical energy. It is related to electric power only. See, electrical energy is something. See, if we use any appliance, say electric bulb, for 5 minutes, 1 second, 10 seconds, it consumes electricity. How much it consumes electricity depends on the time period you use it. That is the electrical energy. So it is defined as, you can write it down, it is defined as product of power and time. So formula can be written as E is equal to P multiplied by T, power into time. SI unit, energy unit, always is joule. Either it's mechanical, electrical, kinetic, potential, any energy, its unit always remains same, that is joule. So see, here are also other formulas of electrical energy. For example, formula of power was VI. So I can write E is equal to V I T. There was one more formula of P, that was I square R. So energy formula can be written as I square R T. So there's one more formula of power, I square I square R T. And there can be third formula of electrical energy, that is V square by R T. So three formulas for electric energy also. So you can remember it by remembering the formula of power. Power is VI. So energy is VIT. Power was I square R. Energy is I square RT. And power was V square divided by R. So energy is V square by R into T. So similarly as power, it has also four formulas. But just you just have to multiply it by time. And it becomes electrical energy. There's one more thing related to electrical energy. That is the commercial unit of energy. Commercial unit. Commercial unit is something that is used in our day-to-day life. See, we consume electricity. So the energy is measured in commercial unit. The commercial unit of electric energy that we use in our homes is kW and H. kWh means the full form of kWh is kilowatt hour. This is the full form of kWh, kilowatt hour. So in our homes or in our buildings, in our schools, in our hospitals, the electricity that is used is measured is not in joules. It is measured in kilowatt hour, right? Now the next topic that you all have to do is relation between both the units. Relation between kWh and joule. Now see how I'm going to find out the relation between both the things. See, 1 kWh is equal to 1 kilowatt multiplied by 1 hour. 1 kWh equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. Now in 1 kg, how many gram? 1000 gram. So similarly, in 1 kilowatt, there would be 1000 watt. And in 1 hour, how many minutes? 60 minutes. And how many seconds? 60 seconds. Now if you solve this, 6 6 is 36 multiplied by 10. How many 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This can be written as 3.6. 3.6 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 joule. This is the relation between kilowatt hour and joule. 1 kWh has 3.6 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 joule. This formula can be used to convert electric energy from either kilowatt hour to joule or from joule to kilowatt hour. So if you are converting anything from kilowatt hour to joule, what you have to do? You just have to multiply it by 3.6 multiplied by 10 to the power 6.